Hello everyone, it's Friday, it can only mean one thing. It's time for our virtual celebration assembly. I hope you're all well. Warm welcome to you all, warm welcome to all the grown-ups. Thank you for joining us. And we're going to start our assembly the way we start all of our assemblies, by saying our school prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear God, thank you for loving me. Thank you for taking care of me, listening to me at home, working with me at school, and sharing yourself with me at church. Help me to try my best in everything, especially in loving you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so let's get this show on the road. And first up, let's have a look and see who has had the most progress in athletics this week. So well done to Matiwas, Millie, Galila, Haneel, Rashane, Kundi and Ayana. Well done. And also for our Lexia usage this week. So Evie and Ruby always consistently using Lexia. Well done to you girls. Basabe has had a really good week. So has Jemima, Daniel, Welmy, Oliver, Dennis, and Psalm. Psalms has clocked up an enormous amount of minutes. So well done to you all. Really good to see that you're making good use of your online learning. Okay, remember, log on if you can. I saw lots of children have logged on for maybe just a few minutes, and I think the if you could just do 15 minutes a day, it would make such a big difference. So do try and log on if you can. Okay, next up, it is birthday time. So this week, I'd like to say happy birthday to Lakeisha and happy birthday to Ava. Happy birthday, girls. And I'm sure you would agree. So last week we kicked off with a art competition, and over the next few weeks we are going to be having different competitions each week, but the first one that we started off with was Saint Scholastica's art project, and the title of the project was Reborn. We asked you to research artists who work with unwanted everyday materials that otherwise would end up in the bin, and these artists give a new lease of life to these discarded objects and the materials, so the items are reborn as works of art. And we asked you to have a go at doing that, looking at some everyday unwanted materials and see if you could make them reborn into something new. I have to say, the competition was fierce. It was a really tough decision, and you can see some of our entrants there, from children all across our school. Thank you so much for your entrance. It was so good to see so many wonderful creative ideas, but obviously there can only be one winner. So I would like to say congratulations to Caitlin. You can see there Caitlin's work. Well done, Caitlin. A prize will be making its way to you. Now, we also had some teachers who joined in with the competition, and I didn't realise how competitive they all are. You can see there are some fantastic examples there. So I had a bit of a chat with Miss Joyce, and we looked at all of them and we thought there was only one winner. And that person is Mr. Blackham. Well done, Mr. Blackham. Now remember, we are going to be running different competitions each week, and they can be found on the school website. If you head over to calendar and news, and then you just go down to school competitions, all of the information is there. Send your entries to support@saint-scholastica.hackney.sch.uk. Now then, one thing I wanted to think about is the competition for this week. So this week we were thinking about George Floyd, and in our assembly on Monday we looked at empathy, understanding, and the Black Lives Matter movement. This week there's a t-shirt competition. There's still time to enter because it doesn't close until Sunday. So we want you to make a design to support the Black Lives Matter movement. And I have already had a little look at some of the entries that are coming in. Not made any decisions, but I've been having a little look, and the standard is high. So you've still got time, so give it a go. Get your grown-up to take a picture, email us in your entries. So now we get to the point in the assembly where we start to think about our Head Teachers Award. And sometimes we try and link it to our super skills. This week I've had nominations for four children, and I'll tell you why now. So first up is Trident. So I got a message from Miss Joyce explaining that Trident, during their online lesson, had shown such good participation. Really, really determined to join in. And when he gave an answer, it was full of description, a really good descriptive sentence. So well done, Trident. Next up, from Benjamin and for Alexis, again from Miss Joyce, she said that they had submitted some really wonderful homework, really aspirational in what they'd done. And we saw that Alexis had submitted something for the competition as well. So well done, Alexis. Well done, Benjamin. And last but not least is Lakaya. So Lakaya's mummy emailed in and just said that she's really proud of Lakaya's achievements this week, and I should give her a special mention. So well done to those children. So remember, grown-ups, if you want to nominate your child for anything they've been doing over the past week, then email us on the school email address, or let a member of staff know when they call you during the week. Next week, I'm going to be asking teachers to nominate children from their online lessons. So I'm throwing a challenge out there to you. What super skill can you use, and can you show it to your teacher in your lessons? And just before I go, just a reminder about Microsoft Teams. So we've been using this now for a few weeks, a couple of hiccups this week, but we've managed to get it all sorted. And I'm hoping that many of you will have been online. Grown-ups, if you need support with getting your child's login details, please call the school or email. More than happy to help. And just a reminder about those rules. They should be up in your class or your virtual classrooms. But just a reminder about making sure that you're ready, you've got everything that you need, or they're on time. Remember, grown-ups, you do need to be present in the room when your child is doing on their lesson. Mute that microphone and only turn it on if your teacher tells you to. Make sure you are listening, because you don't want to miss any important instructions. And once the lesson has ended, hang up, use that red icon. Only chat to answer questions when your teacher has asked. And remember, all the school rules apply in a virtual lesson. Remember to be a good digital citizen. Okay, so that's it from me this week. Again, lovely to be all together and to share this assembly with you. I'm back on Monday for another gospel assembly, and we'll be thinking about a little bit more, building on the work that we did this week around racism, anti-racism and inequality. So have a good weekend, and I'll see you on Monday. Bye.